just a quick show of hands, who's been to the History of Science Museum before? A few hands.
What do you notice about this bone?
It's got lines on it.
Exactly right, it's got lines all the way along it. Now this bone is actually 35,000 years old, and people were counting at that time.
It's really interesting to see how even like throughout history they were still using resources to help them with maths.
I used to think that Roman numerals were really hard to understand, but after today I realised that they're not hard at all.
We've got IX, because it's 1 before 10, so that must mean 10 is what?
So both a measuring instrument and a calculating instrument, all to do with time, the dial rotating a little bit like a clock.
Normally science and religion like clash and they don't normally sit with each other, but this time they actually did and I was like shocking.
I just thought it was a cool way of learning how like society was learning about science and stuff.
Yeah, it was interesting to find out how the two, science and Islam, kind of linked together, and if you go back quite a way you can see that they actually have lots of the same roots.
The technology worked really well, so there wasn't really any problems with that. It was very easy to set up and it just means that the kids have access to a type of learning that I wouldn't normally do. I wouldn't normally be doing something with how Islam and science are linking together. I don't necessarily have the expertise for that. And actually, there's a huge amount of value to that, particularly to the children who are in the classroom who are from those backgrounds.
The fact that we had objects that we could see that we were being taught about was quite helpful because you actually had it in your hands. You could look at all the details and how, like, in detail it was.
This is a nice sort of halfway house where, okay, it's not quite a museum, but they've got new information and they've enjoyed it, and I think the enjoyment is the really, really important key part of that.
I want to do it again.
It was great, yeah, I also want to do it again.
It was something different than, I like what we usually do, but it's like nice to have a little bit of change.
Yeah.
We made some bracelets and they were our names, or the first letter of our names, in binary code, and we kind of like showed that with black and white beads on a pipe cleaner.
They all wanted to carry on going, so they just had to do the first letter of their name, whereas a lot of them ended up going to do their whole name or their first letter and their surname.
It went into all subjects, maths, science, art, and computing,
and history.
So that was like five subjects in one.
I definitely would recommend sessions like this to other teachers. We were getting all of the advantages of it being online, with it being low travel, low cost, low disruption, and also bringing experts into the classroom. You're not taking away from the real joy of being in school and being able to share it with your friends. We get all of the learning, we get all of the visuals that we need, and then they apply them in context using the resources and their friends for help.